Well, hey, I'm glad to see you again in the third installment of my From the Front Seat devotional series. And I really have to say thank you to all of you who have made comments on this series. That yes, I know it's a bit folksy, but I do hope you have been inspired in some small way by my tidbits of sharing. Now, I have to throw in a commercial here, because Naomi and I just happened to drive to Martinsburg, Missouri this past Saturday after the community breakfast, not on this old 38, because we heard there is some darn good barbecue out there in a little barbecue stand called Okie Doke. Well, you know what? It was some of the best barbecue I've had in a while. And there behind the counter was our own church member, Clint Wilson. His lovely wife, who is expecting soon, Angie, sitting nearby. So not only enjoying some great brisket and good fellowship with Clint's grandpa, dad, and mom, but his mom even shared that she enjoyed my thoughts from last week's front seat. So I guess folks all around the area are listening and watching. So give them some business up there and tell them Pastor Jeff sent you. Well, we are 1 week away from Turkey Day, and many of us don't know if we're going to have family or not coming. You know, I bought a 24-pound turkey, thinking that some of our family is coming, but also bought a 3-pound turkey breast in case it's just Naomi and myself. I bought some of the other side dish items, of course. Everything depends on the virus, doesn't it? And I sure don't want to bake several pies when it's only Naomi and me keeping the home fires burning. So everything is still up in the air a little bit. Guess it is for a lot of us, isn't it? How do we plan? How do we take all the precautions that we are supposed to? You know, a governor from another state said on the news this afternoon, just wait until 2021 and then we will have a Thanksgiving to be thankful for. Well, I'm still thankful in 2020 for many things, but yet I do acknowledge the tremendous loss of life from COVID-19. I do understand the racial injustice that is played out in horrific scenes across our land. And I can observe the chaos and confusion in Washington over the election and wonder what next. Sometimes we think we are a bit insulated here in our little pocket of Missouri here in Lincoln County. And while numbers are rising, they're rising slower here. We've lost lives to the coronavirus. Don't take me wrong. Each life is precious beyond words. But our number here, as compared with other counties and states, is thankfully smaller. Racial injustice has not been demonstrated in protests or rallies here. Yet that doesn't mean that it doesn't exist here. And the mess in Washington seems so far distant, doesn't it? You know, the year this old Buick was put together in Flint, Michigan, midterm elections had been held on November 8th, right smack dab in the middle of Franklin Delano Roosevelt's second term. The Democratic Party lost 72 seats, mostly to the Republican Party in the House of Representatives. The Democrats also lost seats to the Republicans in the U.S. Senate, so they had a bit of a mess on their hands also in Washington that year. And just a week or two before the election, something else happened that shocked the nation in 1938. In fact, shook it to its core. Maybe you've heard of it, a little radio adaptation of H.G. Wells' famed novel of the time, War of the Worlds. You know, this radio show, directed by future film genius Orson Welles for the Mercury Theater, aired on October 30th. The radio drama began with an announcement that let listeners know that it was not a real news broadcast. However, the problem became that many listeners missed the disclaimer as they were switching stations from another program. The play was broadcast without commercial and was done in a style that emulated real breaking news reports, creating a realistic feeling to the drama. The reports chronicled an alien invasion of the eastern United States unfolding at that very moment. After the play had concluded, newspapers reported that the broadcast had incited a mass panic across our country, stating that many believed the hoax to be real. End of the world stuff? End times as reported in Revelation? People believed. And then late in 1938, Adolf Hitler was inciting the public annexing other countries, creating alliances, and spewing incendiary talk from his Nazi machine. World War II followed not long after, the bombings of London, Pearl Harbor, and soon we as a country were in for the long haul. Buick quit producing beautiful cars like this from 1942 until late 1945, instead building engines for B-24 Liberators and other aircraft. So things weren't all rosy then either. Folks back in 1938 and then the war years had their hands full. And I'm sure Thanksgiving looked quite different for everyone. So here we are in 2020 on the verge of giving the boot to this year that has caused us such great pain and misery. And so what are we thinking about for Thanksgiving this year, and how do we approach the coming advent of Christ? I have an idea, nothing earth-shattering, but thought-filled. When Pastor Seth helps me get this production together, the first thing I tell him is, give me a few minutes. Not because I need to get my act together, well, maybe I do, but I have to move the car. I have to bring the car over from the house and get it into position here at the church, and that's no easy task. Now, I'm sure you're saying, what's the big deal? Start it up and drive it over. Well, it's 82 years old. How fast does an 82-year-old move? I have to lift the hood, I have to turn on the battery, then I have to get in and engage the ignition, I have to pull the choke and press the ignition switch. No automatic choke, no electronic ignition. The old Dynaflash straight eight starts humming and whirring, and I hope and I pray it will fire on the first round, but generally not. Once it engages and comes to life, it coughs a few times, and then it starts chugging. I wait, I accelerate a little, and then foot in on the manual clutch to shift into gear to move, hopefully. It takes time. You can't be in a hurry. And is that all right? Of course. You don't rush your 82-year-old grandma, do you? You don't tell her to get the lead out. You just wait. And you savor the moment, as I do, sitting in this old car with all of its old smells and old noises. You know, the first few days after the car arrived at our home, I would just sit in it in the evening, and I would soak up its history, its feel, its enormity, its sense of culture, and I would think about those who would have constructed it on that assembly line. I'm sure most all of those folks are now past. I've sat in the front seat and the back seat and tried to imagine driving this car in 1938. Wow. Reminds me that we need to slow down for this Thanksgiving, because I think we have a heck of a lot to be thankful for, even though the world seems to be in a mess. I will have food on my table no matter how many are there. I am healthy and try to stay that way. I have all the necessities of life, even though they say toilet paper and paper towels are flying off the shelves. I have my family, yes, around the country, and I'm blessed that they too are safe and healthy. I have my God, my deep faith, and our church, an exciting ministry, awesome colleagues, and church staff to work with. Naomi has her fun fifth grade team. Just catch them on Facebook. They're a hoot. Her students, her school, and her love for education. I have a closet full of clothes, a garage full of toys, a medicine cabinet full of meds that keep my heart disease and diabetes in control. So what more could I want? Psalm 46, verse 10 tells us, "Be still. Be still and know that I am God. Be still, take care this season. Soak it in for all it's worth. Appreciate everything around you. Know that all could change in a flash. Be still, my soul, for God is on your side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Trust in your God, your Savior, and your guide, who through all changes faithful will remain. Be still, my soul, your best, your heavenly friend, through thorny ways, leads always to a peaceful end. Nothing normal about 2020, but there was nothing normal about 1938 either. Take it slow, just like Clint, back at the Okie Doke barbecue, cooks his brisket and his ribs. Slow, so that the meat can appreciate the heat and the spices, leaving you with a mouth-watering tender treat. Enjoy Thanksgiving. Yes, it's different. But take the time to gaze upon your abundance and upon your blessings. Count your blessings like the old hymn called us to do, and then be still and know that God is still in charge. Trust in God that He will take care of you and your family, and that no matter what happens to any of us, He will always be faithful and present, a guide through the thorniest of paths. I don't know about you, but I love Thanksgiving. When I have the time and opportunity to pray deeply, appreciate greatly, and savor the blessings that I have, not only as an American, but also as a Christian. Advent will be here soon. And I'll share a few thoughts next week in my final installment. But it's not here yet. So value this Thanksgiving season for what it's worth. Be grateful. Love each other. Blessings.